Ooh boy, some college football talk, and it doesn't involve the transfer portal. This is usually a topic that most people aren't interested in, but for me, I feel like you have to discuss this because this is another one of those dominoes to fall. So literally just moments ago, like the Ross Dellingers and the Andy Staples of the world and whatnot have announced that the Big Ten and the SEC are creating a joint advisory group of presidents and ADs in an urgent mission to find solutions and steer college sports into the future. Pressures are mounting, SEC's Greg Sankey tells Yahoo Sports. We are not going to be status quo. Anyway, the short version of this is that, you can just call it a power two now. That's the short version. If you happen to be part of the SEC or Big Ten or are going to this coming July, congratulations, you have won the lottery and you will matter for a long, long time, if not forever. I can hear the distant cries of Florida State from Tallahassee. I am in the state of Florida, so I can hear them screaming to get out of that ACC Grant of Rights prison, which they're doing everything they can. They got themselves a little chisel, and they're taking a little bit of dust. They're trying to Andy Dufresne their way out of the ACC one way or another. Maybe they'll bring Clemson or Miami with them or North Carolina, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. And I want to talk about another thing, just so I get this out of the way. I know the Tennessee deal is kind of a big deal to Tennessee fans, and look, I'm not gonna pretend I know the whole particulars of the whole thing. What's interesting about that whole deal is that to me, it's almost irrelevant whether Tennessee did something wrong or not. I know Tennessee fans, we didn't do anything wrong. I genuinely don't care whether you did something or not. I know the whole point is that you didn't do anything wrong, but the rules are stupid, and you're trying to fight both battles here. That's kind of a weird legal, limbo mumble jumbo that we can let someone else deal with. But you see the signs. I mean, the signs have been around for years, but it's moving forward. The new 12-team playoff, the new way college football landscape's gonna look. If you're not part of the Big Two, you better find something. The NCAA, the current president right now, like a couple months back, has been open about bending over backwards. Like, you know what? We should probably create a new division for some of these top-tier schools. FBS and Division Ones get a little too big, so maybe we make a little super league of all the brand names people care about and whatnot. And yeah, of course they're going to do that because they want to hold on to their precious March Madness tournament. Because if they don't, and all those other schools break away regardless, and then you're going to have that issue of not having those teams people tend to care about. The mid-majors getting upsets in week and the first or second games are neat and all, but you can't have your Cinderellas without your Goliaths and your sprinkle of David here and there, but. It's just at this point, it's just a matter of when, not if. We are moving to like you want to call it the NFC, AFC of college football, fine, whatever you call it, whatever it may be. I mean, listen, the Big Ten has West Coast representation. The SEC is the only real conference left that has like actual regional connection, it feels. I mean, the ACC kind of does, but not anymore with like the weird additions they have in the middle of the country and the west coast of the country. So we're just in this weird transition period right now with college sports. And I'm perfectly fine with it. And it's easy for me to say because I'm an OU fan and Oklahoma's always going to be part of this deal. And, we're just, we haven't even gotten our first taste of SEC football yet. And we feel like more stuff is happening. But, what are the things that are going to change? Well, again, you go back to the Tennessee case, what collectives can and can't do. Should schools have more control over this stuff? Like, I think the idea is like the big schools want to set their own rules. They want to make them realistic. We're gonna get rid of silly stuff like we're not gonna suspend kids for smoking pot. It's 2024. I don't know if you've heard, it's kind of mostly legal everywhere on a medical level. Some of you other states are gonna catch up eventually because you know, if you actually allow people to vote in your states on things, you know, they'll tend to vote for it. But however you may feel about that, I think most of you get really pissed off when you hear one of your important key players is not playing this week because they smoked weed, which is like the least offensive drug at this point you can think of. I'm sorry, Reefer Madness was not real. It was fake. You know, you go on with, like, again, the NIL stuff, which everyone loves to talk about. Talk about how, who can do what and where and who has access to what and who's allowed to make offers. Like, you know, you need some sort of, like, a commissioner in charge. That would be great. But they're going to go with this joint advisory group of presidents and ADs. So another committee. So much fun. But I think for everyone, we're just hoping one day, you know, all the dominoes and, you know, the musical chairs will come to an end, and then we'll know where everyone stands, and we can just play sports. We can just play football, basketball, softball, baseball, you name it. So it's just, I'm at the point where it's like, just let it happen. Just let it happen. And let Florida State out. They, like, listen, you're not going to, like, ACC, just let them out. They don't want to play anymore. They want to join the Big Ten or the SEC, whomever it may be. They want to be part of the big club. They're going to get led in the big club, along with Clemson, probably Miami. I have to wonder about Miami sometimes, but Miami's a brand that people remember, so they'll probably get, I mean, Notre Dame is going to be lumped in somehow because we can't not have Jesus part of the group and everything. But other than that, like, if you're not part of these big two clubs, you better find a way. Because being part of the ACC and this new weird, you know, jambalaya Big 12 is probably not going to cut it anymore. Just like long distance down the road, you see the writing on the wall. If you're not in the Big 10 or the SEC, it is really, you know, all hands on deck. You need to figure out where you stand or else. Maybe not now, maybe not even 5 years from now, but 10, 15, 20 years. Might end up like Nebraska, and they're part of the club just by default because they're in the Big Ten. So they figured this stuff out a long time ago. So I do think that Nebraska joining the Big Ten, despite having like almost no success, is like retroactively one of the best moves they've ever made now, because imagine if Nebraska was still in the Big 12. I'm not saying that, but just imagine if they were. Would you add Nebraska in at this point? I don't know. Like, what are you gaining? But you're still kind of hoping one day you can rekindle that old, you know, Battle of the Big Reds magic with OU and Nebraska. And they played a couple times, and it was just wasn't quite there. The sparks weren't there anymore, but maybe one day. But those are my random thoughts of just news dropping today, just trying to find a topic to talk about with college sports. So for those who will be in the greater Orlando area for tomorrow, I am going to the UCF OU basketball game. I will be on campus. I will be at Edition Financial Arena with my buddy Eric Lopez. He'll be covering the game. And I will just be by my lonesome somewhere once we get the game. Apparently it's a sold out game. I assumed long term or way ahead that this would just be one of those, it's a February game. It'll be half full. No one at UCF's going to care as much, but apparently they do. So, it's a lot easier to get tickets for that basketball game than it is for the softball tickets in late April. If you've been to my, you came to my stream last night, you know what I'm talking about. They want like 120, 30, 40, 50 bucks a pop for tickets. Cause like UCF literally has like 12 seats in their outfield or general admission. So I joke, of course, but literally it's like, Eric says he's going to plan to try to do something to get me in there, but I'm not holding out hope at the moment. Unless y'all want to drop $500, because that's what it's probably going to cost to purchase tickets on Third Market. So maybe I'll get to one. We'll see. This is kind of the off season where I don't make as much money because football's pretty much over, and I'm really hoping we have fun recruiting in spring ball to talk about, and softball starts next week, and hopefully OU just keeps winning, and we have some more fun things to talk about there. So, anyway, with that being said, Boomer Sooner, it's really cool to be in the Power 2. You know, it's really fun. We haven't even got a chance to see what it looks like on TV yet. Here we are making joint committees and just basically projecting where the sport's going to be and probably less than 5 years at this point. So you all have a good one. I'll catch y'all later.